Welcome back. In continuation to the last lecture where we discussed reducing the given well form formula in a propositional logic to conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms, where conjunctive normal form is considered to be conjunctions of disjunctions and disjunctive normal form is disjunctions of conjunctive normal forms. So given a well form formula which is in the form of implication and negation etc. and all, so we will try to reduce it to a given normal form. So what is the use of reducing it to conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms? This is also considered to be one of the important decision procedure method. As usual in any decision procedure in propositional logic, for example if you have taken into consideration truth table or semantic tableaux method or some other methods which we have considered so far, in all these methods what we did is simply is that given a well form formula we are able to check whether a given well form formula is a tautology, and as all of us know all tautologies are considered to be valid formulas, and given a set of well form formulas we also came to know with these decision procedure methods either truth table or semantic tableaux method or this method conjunctive normal forms, reducing the given formula into conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms, we can say that a given formula is satisfiable or not. So under what conditions a given formula is going to be true. Not only that thing, we can also say that when a given formula is considered to be contingent etc. and all. So what we are essentially doing is that a given any complex formula we are trying to reduce it to its corresponding DNF, that is disjunctions of conjunctions or conjunctions of disjunctions, that is CNF. So one of the important observations that we can make out by reducing the given well form formula into a given CNF or DNF, so you have to note that any given formula can be reduced to either CNF, that is a conjunctive normal form, or DNF, that is disjunctive normal form. So these are some of the important observations which we can make out, but before that, so what I am essentially trying to do in this lecture is simply this, that I will be talking about some examples of how to reduce the given formulas into conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms, and then I will talk about some of the important properties of logic, that is satisfiability, consistency, whether or not a given formula is valid etc. and all. And in the second part what I will be doing is as an application of reducing the given propositional logical formula into CNF and DNF, so we will try to see its application in analyzing some simple digital switching circuits. So what we will do in that thing is that a given a complex circuit, so we will transform it using the principles of propositional logic into essentially conjunctive and disjunctive, either conjunctive or disjunctive normal form, and then we reduce the given formula into a simple formula, and that formula corresponds to a simple digital switching circuit. So again we reconstruct the circuit based on whatever simplified formula that we arrived at, and from that you will reconstruct the digital circuit, and then that will constitute to be a simple simplified form of a complex digital circuit. And then we will also see with some examples. So one of the important uses of logic is that it can also be applied in solving some kind of puzzles. So we will also see with the help of CNF and DNF, reducing the formula into CNF and DNF, so we will see that some of the important problems such as knights and knaves etc. which we solved it already with the help of semantic tableaux method, those things can also be solved by using this reducing the given formula into CNF and DNF. So essentially CNF, reducing the given formula into CNF and DNF will serve as some kind of decision procedure method for knowing whether a given a formula is valid or invalid, or when two groups of when group of statements are consistent to each other. So these are the following observations in continuation to the last lecture. So these are some of the important observations that we can arrive at. So a well formed formula A, after reducing it to conjunctive normal form or disjunctive normal form, is valid if and only if it is in the case of conjunctive normal form, if and only if each disjunctive clause in any conjunctive normal form representation of A contains a pair of complementary literals. So what do you mean by a complementary literals? Suppose if you have a literal P, it is considered to be a positive literal, and then the complementary of this one is not P. Usually we represent complementary as this particular kind of thing, but instead of that we are using negation of P. In Boolean logic we use complementary for this one, and then for R we use in Boolean logic we use plus, and for AND it is a multiplication sign is used. So these are the only differences between the Boolean logic and the propositional logic that we are trying to talk about. So essentially they are more or less the same. So what is a CNF? CNF is nothing but a conjunction of disjunctions and all. So first you write this thing, conjunctions of what? Disjunctions. So there are several disjuncts and all till DN. So what do you mean by a disjunct? It can be in this form P1 or P2 etc. So each term in the conjunctive normal form is a disjunction. So in this sense a well formed formula is considered to be valid if and only if each disjunctive clause in the conjunctive normal form contains a literal and its negation and all. So now observe this particular kind of formula. So we have semantics of R, so that is like this, you have A and you have B, and these are the only values that it takes. A takes these values and then alternative T, F and all. A or B, the semantics of A or B, that is truth meaning of a formula A or B is nothing but truth conditions of A or B and all. So that is going to be false only when both disjuncts are false. In all other cases it is going to be true. So now this given formula D1 and D2 to DN, so this is going to become true if and only if all the disjuncts are true. This has to be true, this has to be true and this has to be true, then only your CNF is going to be true. Then you have established that a given conjunctive normal form is considered to be a tautology. So and as usual, you know, all tautologies are also considered to be valid formulas. So now one observation, important observation is that why we are reducing a given formula into conjunctive normal form is this, that if it so happened that this disjunct has a literal and its negation something like P1 etc. and all, then this is always considered to be true only. So this is nothing but a tautology and all. So now suppose in your disjunction D you already have P1 or not P1, and there are some other letters that exist here, it can be Q, R, S, whatever it is. So now since this is already true, so now it is like X or T, X or some other formula like P something like that, P or Q or something like that. So now since in this disjunct, in every disjunct this first formula is already true and all because of a literal and its negation is there, that means always going to be tautology only. So now irrespective of whether whatever follows after this thing is either true or false, the whole thing is going to be true only because of this particular kind of thing. So the first disjunct is already true, observe these two cases, and irrespective of the whatever disjunct that follows after that one, a literal and its negation, suppose that happens to be true, is also true, and the next literal that occurs after the negation and its negation, literal and its negation, that is considered to be false, then also it is going to be true only. So in that sense if each disjunct have to be true, there should be at least a literal and its negation has to be there. If a literal and its negation is there, then that disjunction is automatically turning out to be true only. So in that sense if each disjunct, it so happened that each disjunct has a literal and its negation, then all the formulas, all the disjunct that occurs in the conjunctive normal form are going to be true. In that sense this your given CNF is going to be true. So in that sense a given formula is considered to be a tautology. So now let us consider some simple examples with which we will establish this particular kind of observation. So we know that this particular kind of formula P implies Q implies P, so that is a theorem or a valid kind of thing, is also called as paradox of material implication, which we will not go into the details of this one, but it is a theorem in propositional logic. Suppose if you write like this, it's a theorem in general propositional logic. So now as a first step in CNF, in conjunctive normal form, which is a conjunctions of disjunctions and all, so what you will do is you will start eliminating this implication. So you eliminate this implication by using this particular kind of rule. X implies Y is same as not X or Y. What essentially you are doing is you are reducing this implication to simple disjunction and its negation and all. In the final formula, what you will find is you will not find implication and all. This sign you will not get it, but only signs that you will come across is negation or and conjunction. So in that sense you are reducing the given formula into CNF. So now as a first step, so what you will do is so now the whole thing is taken as X. So now X implies Y means not of P or Q implies P. So this is the first step that we are trying to see. So now this bracket should be there. So now you reduce the, you eliminate this implication, then you will get not Q or P. So this is not P or whatever is there here is the one which we have written, and the second step this will become this. So now what you can do is you can use distribution law and all, or associative law. This will become not P or not Q, or P or not P. Not P or not Q, and not P or P. So now observe this particular kind of disjunction. This is, so this particular kind of disjunction, now observe this particular kind of thing, it is in this form X or Y. So now since this is already true, P or not P is also always considered to be true only. So now irrespective of whether this formula is going to be T or F, this is always going to be true only because of the semantics of disjunction. So one particular disjunct is true, then irrespective of whether this whole term is false or true, is going to make the whole disjunct true. It is in that sense, so this formula is going to be a tautology. So this is one way of representing one particular observation is that in a given well-formed formula, suppose if it so happened that a literal and its negation occurs, then that is considered to be a tautology, and it is also considered to be a valid formula. So similar kind of thing which one can do with the help of a truth table also. For example, suppose you know that this formula is always considered to be valid only, so that is a law of contraposition, P implies Q is nothing but not Q implies not P. So now from the truth table also one can draw the CNFs and DNFs. So now there are two variables here, P and Q, that is why there are four entries that are possible. So now then you need to take into consideration P implies Q, then the next one is not Q and not P, and then not Q implies not P, and then the final one is this one, the whole thing. So that is P implies Q implies not Q implies not P. So now just quickly we will construct the truth table and all. So since there are only two variables in the truth table, there are only 2 to the power of n entries will be there, 2 to the power of n rows are going to be there, so there are 4 rows which are possible. So now in this case T T F and F, T F, alternative T and alternative F is the one which you write. So now P implies Q is going to be true, is going to be false only in this particular kind of case. In all other situations, so that is going to be true. So in all other cases it's going to be T. So this is all we know about material implication, that is P implies Q is nothing but not P or Q. So now not Q is exactly the opposite of these things. So now whenever it becomes T, it becomes false. Whenever it is F, it is T, and F and T, and not P, this one, this is FF and T T, exactly the opposite of these values. And all when P takes value T, not P takes value F. So now not Q implies not P. So now this formula is going to be false only in this case. So that is when the antecedent is true, the consequent is false. This is going to be false. In all other cases it becomes T. So now you need to observe the implication of these two things. So that is going to be your final formula. So why we are, what is that we are essentially trying to do is that from the truth table also you can make out, you can write disjunctions, DNFs and CNFs. So now this one, now we need to check whether there is any formula in which P implies Q is T and not Q implies not P is false. So now this is the antecedent in which your three T's are there. So now we need to check whether there is any formula in which your antecedent is true and the consequent is false. So now you will observe that there is no way, no row in which you have P implies Q T and not Q implies not P false. It is in that sense all are going to be T only. So all these things are turning out to be true. So now what we can do is this thing. So from the truth table one can construct one can construct a DNF or CNF. Let us see how we do it. So now for the DNFs you take into consideration all the things which are true, all the rows are true only. So now we start constructing this thing, conjunctive normal form for this one. So now what are the values for this one, what are the rows in which it is true, in all the rows it is true only. So now it is like this, either P and Q, P and Q are, so now the next formula is R, P and not Q R. So now this one, so that is not P, whenever it is P is false it is represented as not P, and then not P and Q R, this one both are false, not P and not Q. So what essentially we did is this thing, that so it is like C1 or C2 or C3 etc. So now what is this C1? It is in the disjunctive normal form, so where each disjunct is a conjunction. So this is like should be written in this way, D1 or D2 or D3. So where each disjunct is a conjunction. So how did we essentially write this one? So under what condition this whole formula is going to be true? So now when P takes value T and Q takes value T, that is one particular kind of condition under which this formula is going to be true. And then you have P and not Q, in that case it's going to be T, and you have to list out all the rows in which this formula is going to be T. So this is what we have at the end, so that is in the form of disjunctive normal form D1 or D2 or D3, where each D1 is a conjunct. So this is in the disjunctive normal form. So now from the truth table one can make out, you can write down the corresponding DNF or CNF. So that is one way of doing it. That is what is the important observation that we can make out here. So from the truth table also one can construct a corresponding DNF or CNF. So now the second observation is that a given well-formed formula is considered to be unsatisfiable if and only if each conjunctive clause in any DNF representation of X contain a pair of complementary literals. So if it so happened that in a DNF disjunctive normal form, it so happened that you have both P and not P is there in any one of these formulas in each and every disjunct, then all disjuncts will turn out to be false. In that case a given DNF is going to be false, then it is said to be unsatisfiable. So for example in this case P implies Q and Q implies R and P and not R, so that is considered to be unsatisfiable because in the last term in particular P and not R, so that is having a problem, so that is why that form that term is going to be false, that makes the whole makes the conjunct false and all. So when a formula X contains a pair of literal and its complementary that is not P, then in the given form that the whole formula is going to be false and all, so that makes this form unsatisfiable and all. So let us see why it is a case that P implies Q and P implies Q and Q implies R and P implies P and not R. So you add to this one why it is considered to be unsatisfiable enough. So now it is like this thing, first one can be written as this one. Now we are trying to say why it is considered to be unsatisfiable and all. Let us see whether it is unsatisfiable or not. So now the first statement can be written as this one, P R not P R Q, and the second one is not Q R R, that is the second one, and then the third one is P and not R. So this needs to be transformed into this one, not P R Q. Now the second you write it in this way, not Q R R and so this can be written as this one, use De Morgan's law and then convert it into its corresponding disjunctive form. So it is P and not R will become not P R R. So why it has become like this, P and not R is nothing but if you take the negation into consideration, you have to take the negation of P and R. So now if you see this one, not of not P is P only, not of disjunction is conjunction and this is not R, so this is same as this one. So now why this formula is considered to be unsatisfiable. So now we need to further reduce this particular kind of formula and then you will see why it is the case that it is going to be unsatisfiable now. So now there are several ways of showing that whether or not this particular kind of formula is unsatisfiable or not. So first there is a method which we came to know, that is a semantic tableaux method. Using that you can see whether it is unsatisfiable or not. So now you can write it in this way, P and not R is represented in this way. So now this formula is checked and all. So now we are using semantic tableaux method just to see whether it is unsatisfiable or not. So when these three formulas are going to be unsatisfiable, when you construct a tree for these formulas and all, if all the branches closes then that is considered to be unsatisfiable. If at least one branch is open, so that is considered to be satisfiable. So now we will come back to this particular kind of format little bit later. So now we are checking it with semantic tableaux method whether it is considered to be satisfiable or not. So now this is not Q and R, so this in this way you can write it. So now you have R here and not R here, so this is contradictory to each other, so this closes, and then so whatever is left is this one, not P and Q. So now P and not P closes, and you have Q and not Q, this also closes. So now from this method we can make out that these three statements are inconsistent to each other. So now according to our this thing, so this is in CNF, it is a conjunctions of disjunctions and all. So this formula, if it has to be false and all, if this is going to be false, if all this at least one of this disjunction is false and all, then it is going to make the whole conjunct false. When do you say that P and Q is false? At least one conjunct is false, then you can say that the whole thing is false. So there are ways to say that. So now what we observation tells us is that a well-formed formula is said to be unsatisfiable if each conjunctive clause in any DNF representation of X contains a pair of complementary literals and all. But here the formula is in CNF, so now we need to convert this formula into corresponding DNF and all. So if you take the negation of this whole formula, then it will be converted into the corresponding DNF and all. So that is not P or Q and not Q or R and not P or R. So now the negation of this one is this one. So now this will become not of not P or Q. Now negation of conjunction will become disjunction, and then each term will be like this, and negation of conjunction will become disjunction here, and again negation of not P and R. So now so what essentially we are trying to do is the formula is in CNF, but we are trying to convert it into disjunctive normal form. So once you convert it into disjunctive normal form, then we are we make use of the observation that is a term which consists of both a literal and its negation, then that conjunct has term will be false and all. So now this translates into you have to use De Morgan's laws, then it will become P and not Q. Not of not P is P, not of Q is not Q. So now this is R, now this will become Q and not R. Now R, this is P and not R. So now this is in the disjunctive normal form, that is D1 or D2 or D3, where each disjunct is a conjunct. So like in this first case, D1 is nothing but P and not Q, and D2 is Q and not R, and D3 is P and not R. So now one of the important observation is this, that whenever your disjunct, that is which is nothing but a conjunct here, P and not Q, a literal and negation and all, P and not Q, in each one of these terms a literal is there and the unnegated form and the negated form is there and all. If you have Q and it is not R, and then P not R, etc. and all. So that makes all these things false. In any given DNF, this is DNF of your formula in this case. So in your DNF, each conjunct is having a literal and its negation, or sometimes it need not have to be its own negation, but negated formula and unnegated formula, and unnegated literal. Then obviously that disjunct D1 has to be false, and hence and since each disjunct is false, that makes the whole formula false and all. So that is what is the important observation that we can make out. A well-formed formula A is considered to be unsatisfiable, that means the formula is going to be false if and only if each conjunctive clause in any DNF, so that is here in this case P and not Q, Q and not R, P and not R, you will see negation and unnegated term and all, unnegated term is followed by a negated term. So in that case all the D1, D2, D3 are going to be false, and hence the formula is going to be false, that is why it is considered to be unsatisfiable. So we can also show that a given formula is valid or not by again reducing it into conjunctive or disjunctive normal form. So these are some of the important observations which one can make out. So these are the two important things which are directly related to satisfiability of a given formula. A formula in conjunctive normal form is considered to be valid if and only if each of its disjunctions, because in conjunctive normal forms is a conjunctions of disjunctions and all, so in each of such kind of disjunctions it contains a pair of complementary literals like P not P and all, so then each conjunct is going to be true, so that means all the the whole formula is going to be true, that means tautology, and hence it is a valid formula. And conversely, a formula in DNF like this, the one which we have explained it on the board, is considered to be unsatisfiable, that means it is going to become, the formula is going to become false, that means it takes the value 0 if and only if each of its conjuncts contain a pair of complementary literals like P or not P or P and not Q, etc. and all. So the idea here is that if one formula is one literal is true and the other literal is considered to be false, it makes the whole formula, whole D1 false only, since all disjuncts are false and the given disjunctive normal form, whatever formula that exists in the disjunctive normal form, D1 or D2, D3 all are false, so hence D1, D2, D3 the DNF is going to be false, that means it is going to be unsatisfiable. So this we make use of it in solving puzzles also. While solving the knights and knaves puzzles, we translate the statements into the appropriate language of propositional logic, and then we say that either we write it in the CNF or DNF, usually we write it in the CNFs, conjunctions of disjunctions, then if whether or not we'll check whether or not a given formula is satisfiable or not. So usually knights and knaves puzzles are translated into those problems in which it is usually satisfiable and all, that makes the, some of these sentences true and all. So then we will look for the solution whether or not a given person who is talking about something is a knight or knave and all. We will come to it little while from now. So now this is an important theorem which is worthwhile to mention here. A clause P1 or P2 or P3 etc. is considered to be valid if there exists some I and j such that that pi is equivalent to not pj and all, that means a literal and its negation exist in a given formula, then obviously it is going to be valid. A conjunctive normal form C1 and C2 C3 where each C1 is a disjunct is going to be valid if each of its clauses ci, that is D1 or D2 D3 are true and all. If all these things are true, C1 is true and C2, C3 all are true, then obviously CNF is going to be true, that is it is a tautology and hence it is a valid formula. So now in the examples that are there here, not P or Q, P or R, so that is considered to be valid because if you rearrange it in a certain way then it will become P or not P, Q or R. So at least if P or not P is already true, we know that it is a tautology, so then the whole formula is obviously going to be true irrespective of whether P and the other prepositional variables, whether it takes truth or false, then it is going to be true. So that makes the whole formula true, that means all true prepositions are considered to be tautologies. In the second case also we have a literal and its negation in C1 and C2, so a literal and its negation is there, that is why that makes C1 true. For example, C1 is nothing but not P or Q or P. So in that P or not P is already there irrespective of whether Q is true or false, the first C1, the first term C1 is going to be obviously true. In the same way in the second term R and not R, a literal and its negation is there, it is always going to be true, hence both the terms are true, it is going to be a tautology and obviously all tautologies are considered to be valid formulas. So now let us try to solve some simple examples while making use of this particular kind of idea, that is a literal and its negation exists in a given CNF, then that formula is going to be a tautology and hence it is a valid formula. So now in these kinds of puzzles we are trying to look for the satisfiability or unsatisfiability of a given formulas and all. So what we essentially we do is like this. Let us consider a simple example which we already discussed it in the context of semantic tableaux method, but again we try to do the same thing with the help of converting this particular kind of formulas into conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms. So here is a story which goes like this. There was a robbery in which lots of goods were stolen, and it so happened that the robbers left in a truck, and it is also known to us that these are the some of the things which are known to us. Nobody else could have been involved other than only these three persons, that is A, B, C. So no D is involved in this particular kind of that information we are sure of. And the second case is this, that C never commits a crime without A's participation. So wherever C is there, you can surely say that A is already there. So now the third thing which we already know is this particular kind of thing. B does not know how to drive. That means if B comes alone out of all these things, stolen goods and all, he cannot flee, so he cannot run away because he don't know how to drive the truck and all. That means he needs help of either A and C. So now with this information we are to whether or not we need to show whether A is innocent or A is guilty. So now this problem requires some kind of representation. So that is when I say that A, B, C, etc. and all, A is guilty, B is guilty, C is guilty and all. If I say not A, not B, not C, then A is innocent, not B means B is innocent, not C means C is innocent. So that particular kind of representation is what is needed in the beginning of solving this particular kind of problem. So what essentially we are trying to do is we translate the given English language sentence into appropriately into the language of propositional logic, and then we try to convert it into CNF and DNF, and from that you can make out when it's going to be satisfiable and all is the one which we are trying to look for. So now the first statement can be represented in this way: nobody else could have been involved means either A is involved or B is guilty or C is involved, either one of them is guilty and all. C never commits a crime without A's participation, that means C implies A. So now third statement: B does not know how to drive. So B, if B has to be accompanied with A, that is the first sentence, or B has to be accompanied by C, that's why B and C. So now we have set of formulas and all. The first one is obviously in particular kind of format A or B or C. Let us consider it as a term C1, and the next one you need to change it into appropriately into a corresponding form and all. So now given these formulas, we are trying to check whether by reducing these formulas into conjunctive or disjunctive normal forms, we are trying to find out whether A is guilty or not. So now let us try to convert this formula into corresponding normal form and all. So now this is the thing which we have. So these are the three formulas that we have. So that is, first one is A R B R C conjunction. The next statement is C implies A, and the third one is B implies B and A. This bracket should be there here in particular, or B and C. So now it looks like that it is like in this particular kind of format C1, C2, C3, C1 and C2 and C3. So that is why it is called as CNF. I mean, you cannot call it a CNF at this stage, but we need to convert these things, each and every formula, into conjunctions of disjunctions and all. So this is already all disjuncts only. So now this is as it is A R B R C. So this is a disjunct only, and you need to write this thing as not C or A, and you need to convert this thing into corresponding normal form. So that is, So now this whole thing is taken as x, I'm sorry, y, and this as x. So then b implies, x implies y is not x or y, so that is not b or the whole thing. B and A or B and C. So what we are essentially doing is we are reducing this formula into its corresponding normal form. So these things are already transformed into corresponding disjunctions in form. So D1 and D2, etc. and all. So now this is as it is A or B or C, and not C or A. And now this is the one you have to use associative law and all. So then this will become not B or B and A, or this is the first one, or not B or B and C. So this is the second kind of thing. So now we have to further reduce it into this particular kind of format. So now you have to use distribution laws here. So this you need not have to do anything here, it will remain as it is. So now we need to convert this thing into a particular kind of thing, not B or B, the first one, and not B or A. So this is what it reduces to, or now this one is not B or B and not B or C. So now this formula reduces into this one. So now we know that B or not B is obviously essentially it's going to be T only, so you don't have to worry much about it. So this is always going to be T, usually you represent it as this letter T. So in the same way here, not B or B is also going to be T. So these terms will vanish and all here. So now what will remain here is not B or A, or the other one here is this one. Now this is this particular kind of connection, and not B or C. So now this formula is reduces to obvious tautology and all, this doesn't make any sense. Now this is not B or A, or whatever is there here, whatever is left is not B or C. So now, so what are the formulas that we have now here? So now you need to see this box and all, you have A or B or C, and not C or A, and so not C A, and these are the formulas, not B or A or not B or C. So now this further reduces to this thing. So why, what is, what essentially we are trying to do is that a given given formulas C1, C2, what C3 and all, we are trying to reduce it into its corresponding normal forms and all. And once you reduce it into some kind of format, either CNF or DNF, then we can talk about whether this formula is going to be satisfiable or not. So not B or A or not B or C. So now this reduces to A or B or C, and not C or A is as it is. Now here we can use some kind of associative law and all, then we can say that A or this not B goes inside, not B or not B or C. So now not B or not B same as one not B only. So this is A or B or C, and not C or A, and then A R not B R C. So now we have everything is in the form of conjunctive normal form, each C1, C2 and C3. So now we need to inspect that literal and its negation is there here, it does not matter, even here also negation and unnegated form is there, that makes these two formulas true. And then so now it further reduces to this one. So there is a way to talk about this thing. Once you convert these formulas into a given conjunctive normal forms and all, here is a rule which we use, A R B R C and not C R A. So these two resolves into simple formula, that is A R B and C R not C is going to be true only. So then this reduces to this one. So this is nothing but A R B. So now in the same way A R B R C, B A R B R C, the first term and the last term, that is A R not B R C. So now this resolves into A and B R not B is B and not B cancels and all, and then whatever remains is C A R C O. So this is another term. So now A R C and this term, not C R A. We'll end it in a while from now. Not C R A. So this translates to A. Why? Because A R C and not C R A. Because this translates into, I mean, this reduces to simply A, resolves into A. So now we got this final thing, that we got A is the case and all, so that means A has to be guilty and all. So what essentially we did is clearly is that first you translated the English language sentence into appropriately into the prepositional logic, and then we reduced the non-normal forms into normal forms, and then we came across this particular kind of formula, you know, A R B R C not C R A. If you further simplify it and all, so then ultimately we have these two literals A R B R C and not C R A. This resolves into A R B R A, and A R A is nothing but A only, it becomes B. So this particular kind of method is what is called as resolution refutation method, which we will talk about it in the next class. So how, whenever you, one of the advantages of reducing the given formula into conjunctive normal formula is this particular kind of thing. So once you come across any conjunctive normal form, then you can use this resolution and refutation method to further reduce it into its corresponding formulas. So these two resolves into ARC and ARC and not CRA. So this becomes true only in the case that A has to be true and all. These conjuncts have to be true only when A has to be true, otherwise it is going to be false. So ultimately what we got is this particular kind of solution, that observe this one, A is considered to be the case, that means A is considered to be guilty. So now this is the way in which one can solve some of the important puzzles and all. So now we will move on to one simple example where this particular kind of thing is used. So this can also be used in analyzing some simple digital circuits and all. So I will talk essentially about the basic idea of that one, and I will try to solve one example based on this particular kind of thing, how a given complex digital switching circuit can be translated into a simple kind of formula and all. So now usually in the digital switching circuits whenever you have this particular kind of thing A, this A and then B. Suppose if these two switches are in a series, then usually you write it as A and B. Usually in the case of Boolean interpretation it is multiplication of B. So whenever two switches are in, they are arranged in a parallel kind of thing, let us say there are two more switches like this D and all, then you write it, write this one as, the first one is in the series, that is why you write it as A and B, and these two are in parallel, so that is why you use this particular kind of symbol R. Or in the simple digital switching circuits you can call it as plus operation. So now for example if not D is there, so here the notation is this, that you usually take it in this way, the moment I write B, that means B is closed, you switched it on. Or if I write not B, that means B is open, the switch is off. So that is the only difference here. So this one can be written as B and not D, because B and not D are in a series, so you can write it in this way. So what you will essentially do is that given a simple digital switching circuit, we translated it appropriately into a given propositional logic, and then we try to simplify this formula, and then the simplified formula is corresponds to a simplified kind of circuit. Let us consider one simple example. With this we will end this lecture. So here is this example. So now you have a switching circuit A like this, and you have B, and then it is connected in this sense, C, so these two are connected parallelly, A and this one, and not B is the one which is there here. Now you generate some kind of output and all. So this is the input and you will get some kind of output and all. So this diagram essentially says that the C and A are connected parallelly, and of course A and B are in series, C and A are connected parallelly, and then not B is also connected in a series. So now this is written in terms of propositional logic like this. So the first formula is written as this thing, since A and B are in series, that means both switches have to be on so that current passes through it. Now second one, or it should be like this C. So this is going to be the right kind of diagram. So now this is in parallel, so that is why you write it in this way, C or A, and now this is in series, that is why it is not. So now here are the two formulas, and now these formulas are further reduces to this particular kind of thing. This is as it is A and B, or C or A, and A and B are not B. So now we use distributive law and all. Suppose if you take this as X and this as Y, so now the first term A and B are C or not A, that is the first term, and now A and B are not B. So now this is going to be your second term. So now you need to rearrange it a little bit, and then this will become like this, A R B R C R A as it is, and this will become A R B A R not B, so the first one, and A R, sorry, B R not B. So now again you used distributive law and all, so this will become A R not B and A B R not B. So now so this changes into this particular kind of thing, A and B R C R A and A or not B. So because B or B is obviously true and all, you can ignore this particular kind of thing. So now you have A and B, C or A and A or not B. So with this I try to end it and all. So now observe these two terms A and B. A and B are C or A and A or not B. So now again we need to use some kind of associative law and all. So now this will become A or B, C or A and A or B, this thing. So now use distributive law on this one, it will become A and B or A or C and A or not B A or not B, then A and A or C and A or not B. So ultimately this this reduces to this particular kind of thing. Since A or B and A or B is same, so now so this will become A or not B will become A only because of law of absorption. So this is A or C and what else is the case, what is left, and A or not B. So now this can be written as A or C and not B. So this is what we have reduced it into. So now a complex final remark is that a complex digital circuit when it is transformed in by using the principles of propositional logic, this transformed into this particular kind of thing. So now you start worrying about your circuit and all. So now this says that you have a switching circuit A and then it moves to, it goes to like this and then not B. So now this is going to be your simplified circuit corresponding to this one. So what is given here is this, that a given complex circuit can be reduced into a simple switching circuit and all. So in this lecture what we did is simply this, that we given a well-formed formula, we tried to reduce it into conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms, and then we talked about we solved some kind of puzzles by using this reducing it into conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms, and then we try to see whether we can simplify the complex digital circuit into a simple switching digital circuit. So in the next class we will be talking about a resolution refutation method, which is considered to be an outcome of reducing the given formula into a conjunctive normal form.